warm-up time is over. First up for Korea, number 3, Hoon Dong Cho. 4, Are Eriksen. 7, Melvin Pabre. 8, Jung Yul Kang. 9, Tae Kim. 12, Kwang In Kang. 20, Jun Yong Lee. 22, Seong Min Kim. 29, Jung Han Yoon. 37, Chang Hoon Park. 39, Han Sol Bae. 63, Se Hyun Han. 65, Rasmus Jensen. 72, Seung Hwan Baek. 77, Kyung Hoon Seo. 97, Max Pabran. Head coach for Korea, Joyun Choi. And here's your team for Singapore. 1, Joshua Lowe. 2, Damian Wan. 6, Chi Yong Lee. 9, Nicholas Chua. 10, Yemak Sorina. 14, Ishwarpal Singh. 16, Jun Wei Fu. 17, Sean Huang. 18, Muhammad Akmal Shaharuddin. 27, Chun In Yong. 31, Satish R. 33, Vignesa Pasupati. 34, Kumaresa Pasupati. 70, Tien Hong Lim. 73, Amiro Asri Asman. 77, Tedis Tan. 83, Tia Ting Cheng. Head coach for Singapore, Tin Chuen Lim. I hope you're excited for all the top floorball action happening here in the OCBC Arena. Don't forget to follow us on Instagram and Facebook at Singapore Floorball Series to get the latest updates on upcoming tournaments. Exciting matches ahead. Don't go away.
Crashing into you, baby. A hearty good evening to you and welcome back to the OCBC Arena. This is the Singapore Sports Hub and we are down to our quarterfinal two. It's going to be hot, it's going to be exciting, and we're going to take you through it right through the next three periods. My name is Glenn Mascarenhas. With me I've got Shazli Ramli, who's been not just keeping us company, but he's also been enjoying the games with us and providing us with great insight. Shazli is a former Singapore floorballer and currently spends his time in grooming, well, the next generation of floorballers and guiding them. So here we have it, Singapore face off with Korea. The game starts, of course, in just a little bit. And the reason why, of course, we want to provide you with a bit of information is very simple. Earlier, we had Australia playing New Zealand. Australia got the better of New Zealand to qualify for the World Floorball Championships, which will be played in Switzerland in November. And today, Singapore or Korea, one of these two teams, do have the chance to replicate that very effort. Let's remind you once again that this, of course, is the Men's World Floorball Championship Qualification 2022. And we are into quarterfinal two on day four. So very quickly, let me welcome you back, Shazli. I do hope that you've had your cup of joe and you're still enjoying it, actually. How was the first game for you? It was a bit unexpected for both of us, wasn't it?
Yeah, definitely. I was expecting a slightly closer match between Australia and New Zealand. But definitely Australia really showed supremacy in the game. And really, they killed it off and being consistent throughout all the three periods. And of course, taking chances against Team New Zealand. And you can see they conceded zero goals. And that shows a lot in their defense also. So it's a really good game for Team Australia. But definitely for Team New Zealand, it's something for them to go back to the drawing board and share the experience with the team back again.
Well, I do agree with you, and it's always lessons to take. And I think, you know, exposure at this stage is so important. You just mentioned that yourself. You said, you know, you can never get better playing with teams who are on par or, you know, slightly weaker than you. You've got to play stronger teams again and again. That's how you really get to that level of floorball you need to.
Yeah, definitely. And now, of course, today's game, Singapore and Korea, will be a very interesting game. Both sides, I think it's going to be a close match on both sides. Korea with a close game between Philippines and, of course, with Team Australia. And, of course, Singapore had two games. They won two games against Team New Zealand and Team Malaysia. And, of course, a harsh defeat against Team Thailand yesterday. And I hope today Team Singapore are going to step up. And I believe so. And I believe they will do. And I probably they will have the best game today, for sure.
Now, before we can get to the actual part of the national anthems, which will kick in just a little bit as our teams walk onto, you know, the court, I'm very quickly going to ask you this. Singapore and Korea. Korea, we've seen them, you know, actually improve in leaps and bounds. But Singapore is the home team. This is really, both these teams have a do-or-die effort getting into this encounter. And I'm very quickly going to ask you, how do you think this game is going to pan out? Not asking you to call a result, but how do you think it's going to pan out, knowing that both these teams have a shot at making that four?
Definitely. I mean, for Team Singapore, I think they're going to probably want to have the best game because they have not had the best game for the past three games. So I won't be surprised if they really step up today and play as a team. And of course, utilize the strength that they have with experience, a mix of experience and young players with good technical skills. I mean, Korea, of course, they are dependent on the one of the line, a very strong line. I mean, they have the Parbran brothers and, of course, Rasmus Jensen. These are the players to watch. But, of course, not forgetting their local players also. I mean, scored a couple of goals for the game.
So, very interestingly, we are going to get into, well, the action in just a little bit. But first up, it's our national anthems. Please do rise with us.
Anthems of Korea and then for Singapore.
Thank you.
Please remain standing for the national anthem of Singapore. Take your seats.
Let's get you acquainted with our referees first. It's Hidayat Fayar and Priyanto Yonki who will be our referees for the next matchup. And this, of course, is Singapore taking on Team Korea. So I'm going to be fair here, Shazni, and I'm going to take the Korean lineup, and I'm going to let you do the Singapore lineup. So here we go with the Singapore lineup.
Starting on goal, Joshua Low, number one, playing center, Satish, number 31. Playing defenders, Kumari Sapasupati, number 34, and Chun Ying Yun, number 27. Playing forwards, number 70, Chen Hong, Lim Chen Hong, and number 9, Nicholas Chua.
Our coach, of course, is Lim Jin Kwan, and you know him very well.
Yep, definitely.
And time, of course, to get ahead now with our Korean lineup. And for Korea, it'll be Bai Soon Hwang, who will be in goal. You've got Bai Han Sol in the center. Seo Kyung Hoon, along with Kang Jung Yeol, will be in defense. Park Chang Hoon, along with Cho Hoon Dong, will be in forward positions. Let's not forget, we've got the Barbaran boys coming on later. And then, of course, Rasmus Janssen too in that third change. Head coach is Choi Jo-yeon.
Definitely, these two games we have yet to see the best for both teams, and probably today we will see a good matchup between Team Korea and Team Singapore.
Well, I do believe Korea have a very, very powerful unit. I'm not saying no to this. You've got the Barbaran brothers, you've got Rasmus Janssen. These are lads who are really, really very powerful, very fast. You've got Adi Eriksson, who's a great defender. But let's look at the Singapore team now. You've got the Pasupati twins.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, looking forward for the Pasupati twins to shine today's game. I mean, Vignesa has been scoring some goals for the competition. And of course, Kumaresa has been the controller from the back. And again, of course, another player to look forward to is Akmal Shahruddin, coming back from a long international break. For about 2 years, and then coming back to the international stage. Definitely it's good to have him. I foresee him to be the next big player in Singapore, definitely, but unfortunately the COVID during a 2 year break definitely slows him down a bit, but that doesn't stop him from performing in the international stage for sure.
You've also got a good mate, Fu Junwei, who's an exceptional shooter. You've got Chiang Jae-ching, who made his debut recently, and I think he's been absolutely incredible.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, for a debutant to score goals, it builds confidence for him, and especially at a young age, starting young, good exposure for him, and I hope he can utilize this this opportunity to really to build himself as a player. I mean, he's a talented player, definitely, and of course, it's good to see him perform in this big stage, for sure.
And last but not least, got to make a mention about Lim Jian Hong. To be fair to him yesterday, he was the only lad who had 98% accuracy on the outfield.
Yeah, definitely. And of course, as a small size player, I mean, Lim Jian Hong, he plays with heart. And these are the players that, this is what the boys need to do. I mean, they need to play with the heart and need to get 100%, nothing less for the game.
So it's game on here as Singapore take on Korea. Remember, Korea, of course, were held to a 4-all finish there by Japan yesterday. Singapore fell to Thailand to a 9-1 rout. But today, there's always time for redemption, and seeking it will be the home team here as they go on against Korea.
Looks like Team Singapore is really making a full press on the first shift. Definitely what we needed to push Korea back into their half. I mean, they are dangerous, especially at the opponent's half, so you need to prevent that, especially.
Now you've got the other Pasupati lad to come in, Vignesa. Kumaresa has taken the road out, and Fujinwei has joined him as well, along with Mohammad Akmal.
A good first step session there.
So it's a very good effort coming in from Vignesa. That's through! You needed a finish! And what a finish that is! So Singapore there with the opening goal. Well, just taking Korea by surprise.
Definitely a great play, a great interception from Fujinwei. And of course, a pass from Vignesa Pasupati. And a finish by Akmal Shahruddin.
Well, having two players there, that is really, really, I think, work to the advantage and good understanding between Fujinwei and Akmal Shahruddin.
Yeah, definitely. You know. And you can see this is the things that they want, hunger for the ball. I mean, going for the ball, and you can see they really push up high from the start. Great play from the lads and a great goal from Akmal Shahruddin.
Well, you just mentioned him earlier, and you know he's performed here as well. So it's 1-0 to Team Singapore now. Korea will be very keen to strike back as early as they can. And I do believe they will be looking to turn on the heat here.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, you know, Team Korea, they are a never-say-die team. And, you know, this situation, they always come back for games. But definitely, for that to happen, they really need to push up higher and, of course, to keep possession in the opponent's half in order to create a goal-scoring opportunity, definitely.
Now, Denmark to Lee Chi-Yong. That's another good, you know, shooter. Lee Chi-Yong, he's absolutely wonderful with his scoring.
Yeah, Lee Chi-Yong, I've been in great position. You give him a chance in front of goal, he will definitely finish it. He's definitely one of the players, and definitely one of the tallest players in the team. And using his length and stretching out for ball to tackle and stuff, these are advantages for him.
Well, Satish unable to hold on to that as it's taken away by Max Barbrand. Well, the Barbrand boys too, let's not forget, they are exceptionally talented lads. And there's two of them, of course, in the team. There's Max, who's number 97, and Melvin, who's number 7. You've also got Rasmus Janssen there. And that's the opening goal for Team Korea. They were going to reply, and it's Max Barbrand who powers one through. Joshua Lowe taken by surprise. It's 1-1. It's game on back again here. He was always going to be tough. And, well, I think Team Singapore just taken by surprise.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, a quick reply by the Barbrand brothers from Korea. And a great pass inside from Max to Melvin, and so great finish.
Absolutely. Melvin. So the assist, of course, coming in from Melvin this time, and well, Max with the finish. But normally Max is the more aggressive of the boys when he's in front of the goal. But lovely play, you know, well spotted there, Shaz.
Good job, and we got a game in hand.
Absolutely. Now that goal, of course, has certainly, you know, put a bit of spirit into the Korean lads. They are getting onto an aggressive front here.
I mean, you know, you give these spaces to the Barbrand brothers, you know, finish, and of course, you want to take their chances. I think they scored quite a couple of goals in the blindside area, especially. So these are the things that need to be avoided from Team Singapore to prevent goals against them.
Well, I was a bit fascinated yesterday with the Thai, and I'm going to ask you this with the Thai defense formation. Well, they had three players, you know, manning the back line, and you know, the front. Of course, there were two players constantly, but it was so well knitted or well organized that when Singapore would go at them with a, you know, attack.
Yeah, I mean, definitely.
They were just there to pick it up.
Everything starts from the forward, especially when you are defending. You know, everything moves. If the forward press, the defense is center press, but if the forward doesn't press, definitely they know that, okay, we need to organize, we need to cut off passes. I think they did really well in defense yesterday for Team Thailand. And of course, for the Team Thailand goalie, I mean, he's been having a fantastic competition this year, for sure.
Oh, Yotsupong Chaipring yesterday was just in phenomenal form. He was just outstanding.
Yeah. So he saved quite a number of shots yesterday, for sure. And I mean, give it to them, Thailand. Like I say, offensive sometimes is the best defensive thing in the game. When you have possession, your opponent can't score. And Thailand already kept possession yesterday really well against Singapore.
You're so right about that. Now here's a chance for Team Singapore as they get in. We've got Kumaresa Pasupati now, who's just picked that up from Yong Chun Yin, who sent it back to Kumaresa. But that's dragged a bit off. R. Satish will be missing his brother on the court as well.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, Surya is the captain of the team. And of course, Satish missing his brother because due to injury and stuff. So hoping to see him back in action soon, I guess.
Here's Ishwarpal Singh. It's another lad who likes to shoot from a distance. But Korea have just reorganized the defense. It's a tumble there for Melvin Parbrand. And well, play will continue. There's absolutely no foul there. But there's another well lad, as we said earlier, who does like to take the shot from afar, Ishwarpal Singh.
I mean, you can see a much better patient gameplay from Team Singapore. I mean, they need to avoid all the errors as much as possible.
Like losing the ball.
Yeah. You know, Team Korea, especially the Parban brothers or Rasmus Jensen, these are the players that is going to be deadly in front of goal. So you need to be careful, especially playing in front of them. You know, don't give them chances. And you know, these players.
We just saw that earlier. I mean, yeah. Melvin Parbrand, you know, denied by Joshua Lowe, but that just goes to show how lethal, the siblings are.
Yeah, and it's pretty evident when Korea, they have one defensive line and one attacking line. You can see for yourself for the game. So, I mean, that has been working out for them so far, even though they lost two games. But they have been playing so well with this tactical play that they had for the game.
Chong Huan, who's also in the fray now. Here's Lee. Picked up for a bit, that'll lie loose. And, just a tad bit of a worry there for the keeper, who was failed to hold on to that. Well, almost does it here. Needed to tap that in, but the bounce, of course. I think just flummoxing of Thaddeus Tan a little bit.
Yeah, I mean, much better play from Team Singapore. I mean, getting possession in the opponent's half is very important to keep the play there and being patient and not forcing the pass in. They can, you know, Korea are going to counter fast. You know, these teams, you don't give them space. They're going to utilize every chance they can have to with the ball. So need to be more patient, especially keeping the possession at opponent's half, for sure.
Now, this is the shift of players that really is a problem, you know, just viewing it from here. Kang Kwan In, the captain. You've got, you know, the Parbrand boys. You've got Rasmus Jansen. And then add to that, you know, add Eriksson for good measure. Oh, that is such a near miss. And, well, he's coming to the party, and I'm sure he will. Lim.
I mean, a great interception by Kumaresa Pasupati, bringing up the ball and good vision to find Lim Chen Hong for the shot.
Lim Chen Hong, well, he was, as I said, bang on target yesterday. He was kept away by, you know, Thailand keeper Chaipring, but here's a chance for him today to just make amends for that. That's taken away by Captain Kwang. Adi Eriksson. Here's Rasmus Jansen. Max Parbrand, but that's pulled away very smartly.
One thing I like about these games, this game is the matter of you know, who do the less mistakes, going to take the game, and who take the most chances definitely going to win today's game. There's no one-sided affair so far for the first 6 minutes. So you know, I'm really excited about what's in store for us for the next two periods, I guess.
And I think I couldn't have just highlighted that better. That's so well said, Shazni. You know, which is the team when they're strong or when they're both strong teams, which is the team that really makes a few errors? And, you know, then you pay the penalty for that, you know. You get punished for it. We saw that yesterday. And that, of course, is a deflection that'll find its way through. And an unfortunate moment for Team Korea, but Team Singapore have got the lead. It's now Singapore 2, Korea 1. We are going to give you a view of that. And this is what happened. Mohammad Akmal, very much, well, in the zone here today. They tried to knock that around, and that did come off Seo Kyung-hoon's, well, blade, didn't it?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, great pass down from Vignesh Sapasupati. I mean, of course, the intention to get a pass in to Fu Junwei, but... great effort by Angmar. I mean, he's a big game player. You know, he will step up in these kind of games, and knowing his capabilities, he's able to create this opportunity. I mean, if he's not blocked by the defender, definitely Fu Junwei going to be ready for the shot, for sure.
So, Seo Kyung-hoon, well, gets that goal in, unfortunately, off his own blade. It's an own goal, but all the same, it is Singapore 2, Korea 1, and we're only 7 minutes in. Team Singapore will be very eager to capitalize on that. Well, this game, of course, is going to get physical. Both teams who are on court right now know one thing for certain: it's a do-or-die effort.
Yes, definitely. And then the teams that wins today definitely secure their spot in the qualifiers. We have 3 teams. Now we are left with 1 spot for the qualifiers. And of course, tomorrow's game is the decider. We're going to play the 3rd and 4th placing. But I mean, the qualifiers is definitely more important. And you secure the place there, you'll see yourself for the WFC in Switzerland.
Well, that's so important, isn't it? And here we have, of course, just a tad bit of a worry. Just a collision there. And it is Team Korea will get the better for that call, but not for too long. Oh, that is an absolutely brilliant effort from Lim. So Lim Jin-hong, well, he's a pacey lad. Almost got that right. And that could have been a surefire goal, keeping in mind the fact that the Korean goal was just exposed there.
Yeah, I mean, definitely. I mean, a much better gameplay by them today. You can see they have more hunger, they more spirit to play as compared to the past few games, honestly. And this is by far one of the best period that I've seen Team Singapore play as compared to the first 3 games.
Well, I heard it, and it's just a rumor in the mill, or heard it through the grapevine, that my co-commentator gave them a dressing down earlier.
I know. I miss them, you know, as much as possible. I just trying to be there, just share some words and nothing much tactically,
I heard those words were stern today.
No, it wasn't stern. It's nice. It's positive. And I mean, they're a good bunch. They're a good technical bunch, but it's just a matter of the right mindset coming to the game. You know, they need to have fun and need to be positive and motivate one another and work together. That's important. Because at the end of the day, it doesn't matter who score. I mean, as long as Singapore wins, that matters.
That does. Here's Amirul Azri now. Well, just colliding there with Cho Hoon Dong. And this is what we've been noticing as well today. I mean, as you said, much better effort today from Team Singapore than yesterday. I do love the lads. They're absolutely fantastic, very talented. But I do believe there's a few nuts and bolts that still need to be tightened. Especially losing the ball. It's happened a couple of times. Good opportunity here, but strong work also being done here. Can't put it past Baek Seung-hwan. He's been a decent enough well custodian, and he's got his job cut out for him. Having said that, it's 9 minutes in. Singapore 2, Korea 1. Do remember, this is a game for... It's a second quarterfinal of the day, and this is really a do-or-die effort, keeping in mind the fact that win this game, secure your ticket to Switzerland for November, where you play in the Floorball World Championships.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, knowing Team Korea, they're not going to stop here. I mean, they're going to really keep possession and, of course, trying to get those goals for an opportunity. So, need to be careful in these situations. And, of course, Team Korea, they have good players that can finish in the slot, especially.
Well, they do have very pacey lads. We do know that. And decent enough to block that off.
Yeah.
Stand in the path of Tadia San.
Yeah, I mean, similarities between Japan and Korea. They have pacey players, they have fast players. So that's their strength for many years. So most probably they would love to see them using that more in the game.
Well, I do believe that, you know, we've seen some great magic being worked there. Joshua Lowe keeps that away. And that's just, of course, an exceptional save from Joshua Lowe. He's, well, highly alert today. Well, he was yesterday as well, but I do feel bad. I did believe that he lacked a bit of support on the back line.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, he saved quite a number of shots. I remember he had like 5 to 6 saves in that shift, in the 2 to 3 shifts. So really, he did a really good job in the goal. But I think more support from the defense to step up to the shot will help him a lot, for sure.
So Bike Swing 1, of course, denying Captain Kumaresa Pasupati. Both these lads, the Pasupati lads, do have a fairly strong shot. And I think it's going to be very important for them to perform now.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, as a whole, as a team, you can see that they look really sharper today. Every single touches, every single passes, you can see they are really wanting to get the ball out fast, getting the play out fast. I mean, that's really important in football gameplay.
Well, it certainly is 11 minutes in, and we are, of course, heading towards the last 4 minutes of play in the first period. Singapore would love to knock in another one. Ishra Balsing is fairly close. That's whipped through. Amirul Azri, well, he can be dangerous too, but more power here to the Korean keeper. Well, he's just kept that safe.
Yeah, great slap shot there, but of course the goalie covered the angle well in the game.
Well, I do believe, Shaz, that the two standout teams for me in this tournament I'm not taking any glory away from the Philippines and Thailand, you know, great skill players. Australia, great, you know, team. Singapore also, absolutely talented team. Korea themselves have looked so strong. But the standout teams for me have been New Zealand, who I've seen really improve. It's unfortunate that they went up today against an extremely organized Australian side. But Japan, well, just improving in leaps and bounds. And that's another shot that will be kept away. Lee Chiong is hungry for a goal too. And it's going to be interesting to see what pans out. What a near miss. But 10 on 10 there to keep up by Xing Wan. Oh, that was a solid shot coming from Chung Jiching. We did mention him earlier. He's one of the younger players. But he packs in that hunger, and that's what I like about him.
Yeah, definitely. Good play from Jiching. Breaking in, getting his space for him to shoot. I mean, Chiong is also ready to fall to a rebound. So really good play from Team Singapore. I mean, we were talking about Team Japan, and you know, they improve game by game, and especially with a younger squad, you know, a young team. I mean, they did really fairly well.
So Korea have got an opportunity here. It's going to be fairly close up, and free hits from this distance will tend to be extremely detrimental. But that's kept away. No fire. Singapore's holding tight with their defense. Two other teams, of course,
a bit disorganized in the wall for Team Singapore. I mean, they were wide open. But it's a good step up for the shot from Jiching.
Once again, Joshua Lowe called into action. And just to have a quick look at the teams that are on the outfield. I do remember that Singapore, of course, in Asia would have been one of the pioneers of floorball, really kick-starting that, you know, interest in the sport itself. And then Korea had their peak moments around 2008, 2009. They were an extremely strong squad at that time. And then they just dipped out of the floorball world for a while. But they've come back fairly strong now.
Yeah, definitely. I think since then, this has been one of the strongest squad that they have sent for the competition so far. Looks like
a penalty against
Team Korea for high stick, and definitely a power play and an advantage for Team Singapore to capitalize on this situation.
So it's Baihan Sol who's been called for the high stick, just as you picked it out, and it'll be 2 minutes. So interesting to see if Team Singapore can create something out of it. Here's Baihan Sol as he waits it out.
For Korea's number 39, Baihan Sol, 2 minutes penalty for high stick.
I mean, one thing about the power play, you need to be patient and, of course, moving the defenders, moving the goalies, let the ball move, let the ball speed, do the talking and, of course, getting the pass for the shot in. You need to convert in this situation. And, of course, knowing Korea's defending, they have been defending so many teams and you know that in this situation they are also strong. They're going to cut the passes and they're going to step up to shots. I mean, that has been their forte for the past few games.
Absolutely, bang on about that. Now, here's Lee Chi-young. He's got Fujun Wei around for company. There's also Mohamed Akmal. We've got Sean Huang. We've got one of the Pasupati lads. Team Singapore will have to make use of this bit. It's Vignesa Pasupati. Now, all these lads have got the ability to shoot. And it's Mohamed Akmal who drives that through, but that, of course, just kept away by Mai Chung-Wong. This time it's Lee Chi-young who will be denied. Team Singapore really looking to power that in.
I mean, great shot from Ahmad Shahruddin, and of course, like what they are missing, definitely a screener in front of goal. To go for a rebound. I mean, everyone just spreading out wide, but there's no one getting in the slot area to do the screening of the goalie. I mean, that's very important, especially with power play with extra men. You need to be the one disturbing the defense, disturbing the view of the goalie.
I think you just read my mind there. I was thinking exactly the same thing. You need a backup, and there they finally decided to get one through. So close, yet far, but absolutely fabulous job being done here by the Korean custodian, Bai Chung-Wan, but I think you picked that out very well, Jazz. You need a lad there at all times. And that's been, of course, a bit of a failing for Team Singapore, I think, in the last game. And in this one, of course, they could rectify that. Kumaresa Pasupati pulling that away. We just have about 10 seconds left before the end of this period. It's been fast, it's been furious, and certainly it's been productive. Three goals already in there.
Looks like there's a bit of confusion between the referees and about the timing of the game. Looks like they started with a face-off.
Singapore 2, Korea 1. That's the end of the first period. And a very productive one for Team Singapore. But that's not a huge lead. I think it's a slender lead, and we'll have to keep that in mind. So we are going to get into the next period, of course, which will be in just a little bit. But before we do that, let's not forget to tell you we've got a decent crowd who's coming in. We've got Team Singapore supporters. We've got supporters of the other teams as well. And, of course, it's going to be time for us to lock in. So do stay with us as we, of course, come to the highlights. It's Singapore 2, Korea 1, and here's a look back. And that's our goal scorers in that first period. It is Mohamed Akmalshahr that opened up the scoring for Singapore, barely about 26 seconds in. And then on 1 minute 38, a reply from Max Barbrandt, well aided by his brother Melvin. And that was 1-0 before an own goal, well, unfortunately, coming off the blade of Seo Kyung-hoon, made it 2-1 Singapore. So that's how we end the first period. We'll be back with second period action in just a little bit, in about a little over 5 minutes. So don't forget to join Shazdi and me, Glenn, as we take you through that second period.
Thank you.
Welcome back to, well, the second period here at the OCBC Arena. We are coming at you live from the Singapore Sports Arena. My name is Glenn Mascarenhas, and with me I've got Mr. Floorball Singapore, Shazni Ramli. And let's not forget, this is the quarterfinal number two in the Men's World Floorball Championship qualification 2022 AOFC. The AOFC, of course, does stand for the Asia Oceania region, where only four teams will progress from here to join, well, the remaining teams that will make up 16 in total at the Floorball World Championships. And that, of course, will be held in Switzerland in November. So it's going to be an interesting one. Which of these teams will make it through? Well, your guess is as good as mine. We do have Philippines, Thailand, and Australia who have already qualified and got their tickets to that event today. One more team will join them. Will it be Team Singapore or will it be Team Korea? Shazni, just before we can get into that second period very quickly, I was saying that Korea were a fairly strong powerhouse at one point of time in the late 2000s. And then the focus goes shifting. I do know they're a very, very baseball heavy country. They concentrate a lot on football or soccer, but floorball has got focused back again. They're bringing it back, and we're looking at a really improved and a strong team that we've seen here in action.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, it's good to see the Korean side coming in to this stage and, of course, stepping up to the level where they were way back. And of course, it's going to be a good matchup for Team Singapore also to keep the lead in the second period. And definitely, there might be changes in the game plans for Team Korea or Team Singapore, I mean, approaching the second period. So I'm definitely waiting what the surprise awaits us in the second period, for sure.
Well, I'm totally with you on that. I'm enjoying this game, and I do want to see a fight. I never like to see a one-sided affair, and I'm all for it. I'm all for a game that goes down to the wire as well. Having said that, yes, Rasmus Janssen just gets the nudge over the boards, and it will be a Team Korea, of course, who do get the benefit of that call. Here's Rasmus Janssen. You got Max Parbrand in there along with him. Well, Janssen just sending it right across the court. You got a bit of help there from the captain too, Huang. And this is that shift that I was talking about. These bunch of lads who are currently on court, who really are the dangerous lot for Team Korea. Having said that, yes, well, Lim Jian Hong. I do like to watch him in play because, just as you mentioned, he's a tad bit smaller than most of the other lads, but he's big on activity. And that one being tucked, looking for a way through. Well, unable to hit the target, but he's a strong-armed man, Addy Erickson.
Yep, definitely. I mean, Team Korea have started the game well, started the period well. Good first minute shift from Team Korea. Getting the ball, getting possession back again, and of course creating a goal scoring opportunity again. Good start from Team Korea.
So this is exactly how it all it pans out. Korea, of course, will have read the moves of Team Singapore as well, and I'm sure during that break. And that's the most important part about the break, isn't it, Shaz? That's where you get your strategy reorganized.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, the approach of the game and how you're going to react to how your opponents play is very, very important. And of course, what is your game plan? I mean, what's your gameplay in offense and of course in defense? That matters a lot. I mean, they also had quite a number of games to analyze each other on what the strength and weaknesses of each team. So I hope they have been doing their homework and of course getting back to the drawing board and working on how they can capitalize on certain situations against each other.
Now, one of the flaws that I do believe, and just as you said it earlier as well, you know, I think there's a lot of players, of course, who've got that technique to shoot from afar. They love to drag it through. And that's Baek Seung-hwan with another save as he's denied, well, young Chiang Jiu-ching. But that set piece or that play right in front in the goal now is still much needed. You know, you've still got lads like Ishwar Pal Singh who've got a strong enough ability to drag one through and fire it in. But does that really make sense when you've got three or four players who can stand in front of you like a wall and block it off? And you've got maybe a 2% or 5% chance of knocking it through.
Yeah, I mean, you know, the likes of like Dana Gardner or the Thomas Gardner, you can see, they always like to shoot in this area. But when they shoot, they really move away from players. So that is very important on how you're going to get away from defenders and, of course, finding the slots between the legs or a space for the shots to go through. I mean, that's very, very important, and rather than shooting towards a defender.
Well, absolutely well pointed out there, and this is really a cause for concern when, of course, you're getting into playing a team that is fairly well matched in skill and strength. Having said that, Team Singapore, well, still do have that slender lead. It's not something that they can sit easy with, because there's, I think, just as my good mate Chaz always says, even five goals is just never enough.
Yep, never enough. And one goal, it's just a matter of moments, it can change the game.
So Joshua low keeping. Well, Melvin Pop ran the way. Well, just to reconfirm this, because I got it wrong the other day, but Melvin Parbrand, the number 7, is the older of the siblings. And Max Parbrand, although the 97, although he looks, well, slightly bigger, he's actually the younger by 2 years. Joshua Lowe, a stitch in time, saves 9 here for the Singapore keeper. Absolutely well done. R. Satish, well, getting dangerously close. Now it's Kumaresa Pasupati.
I mean, a pretty risky play from Team Singapore. I mean, especially losing the ball in the middle, you know. Especially against the Parbrand brothers or Rasmus Jensen. These players, they're gonna use this opportunity, you know, to capitalize on the goal scoring opportunity they can have. So
and these are quality players who play on foreign shows.
Definitely.
We know that.
Quality players for sure. And you can see based on the technical skills, you can see these players are really experienced and playing overseas. So. Really, we need to really prevent in order to not make this kind of mistakes, this kind of errors. For the next time, they won't be that lucky.
You're so right about that. Now, you still have a few threats in there. You still have, well, players who can, well, turn on the magic. It's just 3 minutes, 40 seconds in. Let's remind you that tomorrow it's going to be a full day here once again when we have home matches where we will find out who will finish first and second, who will finish third and fourth. But for the time being, the battle is really on for that fourth placement in the World Championship qualification. And who will make it to the World Championships? Well, we've got still one slot available. One of these two teams will claim it at the end of the day. Here's Isharpal Singh. A quick back flick there to Mohammad Akbal. Mohammad Akbal looking for Isharpal Singh back again. And Isharpal, well, picking out. Well, his teammate extremely well. That was Amirul Azri. Azri himself was fairly lethal in the first game against Malaysia. He's just been a tad bit silent, but Mohammad Akmal just making up for that activity. Just as you mentioned, Shaz, I think, you know, a return for Mohammad Akmal, and it really bodes well for him because he definitely wants to make a point, and he's been doing that in the last couple of days. Today, it's a strong chance for him to actually prove that and, well, just get himself a bit of a morale booster too.
Yeah, I mean, definitely. He's one of experienced players right now. Especially, he's supposed to be one of the best right now in Singapore. And of course, the 2 years break affects a little for his performance, but no doubt his mentality is definitely there, you know.
And this can be expensive. Just puts a bit of pressure here on the keeper. You definitely don't want to lose the ball. And just a tad bit of a slip up there from Chiang Jia Ching for allowing. Well, Team Korea to snatch possession. Yeah, Jean-Marc Serena. Well, does well in that area. It's going to be, of course, the benefit of the goal will go to the Koreans. Got the Parbrand boys. And Rasmus Janssen, who stepped in as well. Here's Adi Eriksson off to Captain Kwong.
I mean, to be fair, on the first period, definitely Singapore started well. I mean, one of the best period that they had for the past 3 games. And for Team Korea, you can see in the second period, for the first 5 minutes, I will give it to them. You know, they had more possession. They were keeping the ball well and, of course, create a lot of scoring opportunity for the first 5 minutes of the game.
I think you're so right about that. There's definitely, you know, going to be a chance here for Team Korea to actually get back into it, and I think it really is up to Singapore and the character that they show in this game. Now here's Vignesa, receives it from Mohammad Akmal, gets it straight off the boards, was looking for Fujunwei. Adi Eriksson pulls it away, Max Parbrand taking it forward.
Great skill, great stick work from Max Parbrand. Looks like there's a delayed penalty against Team Korea.
And it was Max Barbrand, of course, trying to have a word there with the official.
Yeah, I think maybe the official would say, am I the ref or are you the ref?
Well, the referee's word is final, and it's Lee Junyoung who will have to serve out the two-minute penalty. So 2 minutes, and that's really a chance here for Team Singapore now to grab opportunity by the horns and probably, well, just get one over, well, the Koreans. Well, this is really a great period of time. 8 minutes left in this period. It's been fairly strong as far as the Korean attack and defense is concerned, but now the power play can Singapore exploit this moment. Big questions will be asked here from Aresa Pasupati.
I mean, if I can remember correctly, I don't remember if Singapore had any conversion on the power play so far. So hopefully to see the conversion and being used in this power play and to capitalize their chances for the
opportunity.
That'd be absolutely
good. Well, I think Nicholas Chua just missing out on that opportunity to intercept that and knock that home. Having said that, here is Seo Kyung-hoon. Now that's really stretching the length of the court. But Joshua Lim said, there's a bird in the sky, let me get it before it drops.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, he has sick throws also. For Josh, he had good throws, and he's been comfortable at the back, and he's been confident at the back, and he had a good competition so far.
Well, fired that one through. Well, just needed to get a tad bit more on the accuracy for Denmark. Well, just keeping the pressure on here for Team Singapore.
In much better movement play from Team Singapore, and a shot goes wide. Good effort, good pass from Kumari Sapasupati, and of course, good effort from Jemak Soreda.
So certainly looks like we've got still a minute left of power play. Can Team Singapore do much with it? Here's Lee Chiong. Got Amiral Azri in, as he will get a bit of help there from...
Team Korea has been doing well in cutting off all the passes, and against these teams, especially with tall build players, you need to really move them a lot more. You need to let the ball move faster. You know, if you watch Thailand, how they play, it's really smooth, you know. We need more that kind of station or that kind of gameplay for Singapore to penetrate in the Korean defense.
Well, one thing I have to say about Team Thailand, and I can't help but, you know, wax eloquent about them, but their passes were so slick. Well, a good stop there by Baek Seung-hwan. Lee Chi-yong, well, has an extremely good ability to find the target, but Baek Seung-hwan, well, just standing up to the occasion, not just once, but twice. And it is the Korean custodian who wins that battle against the Singapore number six for the time being. So just barely about 8 minutes into this encounter. 2-2. And finally, that needed to come through. It took an absolute bit of time, but it needed to come through. And it is. Baek Seung-hwan really having his work cut out for him, unfortunately. And it's now Singapore 3, Korea 1.
Definitely the moment that we are waiting for sure. Getting the power play goal, a great pass from Nick Chua from the corner, and a one-timer shot from Satish in a blindside area. Good opening, great pass, great finish. Good job.
And Satish, of course, makes no mistake there. We do know the quality of his play. Having said that, Singapore 3, Korea 1. And while Singapore will just have to keep that intensity up, there's no way that they can let up on that, because I think even if a tad bit that they do let it up, it's going to change the entire outcome of the game.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, Korea are going to start pushing up higher, especially with the Park Byung brothers. Two goals down, they're going to have the urgency to get back the goal. For Team Singapore, they really need to keep the pace, keep the passes going like how they did so far. They are really doing it well, passing the ball, letting the ball go. I mean, trusting the teammates. That's what is needed from Team Singapore. Much better gameplay for them today as compared to the past three games. And I hope they can continue till the third period.
We just gave you a view of our Satish, of course, our most recent goal scorer. We also had a good shot fired in by Fujun Wei earlier. But now, of course, Team Korea will be very eager to reduce the deficit here. You've still got practically a little under 7 minutes left in this period of play. And anything could happen. The goals could come. Remember, it's that ticket that we're fighting for, that ticket to Switzerland, and not just for one player, for the entire team. So which of these two teams will claim it to find themselves in the World Floorball Championships? Right now, Right. Just a tad bit of work there. Thaddeus Tan being obstructed by Adi Eriksson. And it certainly looks like Team Korea are trying to regroup. They've got a plan in mind. Here's Lim Chien Hong, who stepped in. And remember, Singapore have a close-up opportunity. Tries to whip that through. Oh, he's got the ability, but can Team Singapore will make the most of it? So Nicholas Chua also looking very lethal in today's game.
Yeah, he's been finding good passes, finding his teammates really well today. You can see great vision from Nicholas Chua, trying to get a pass to Satish or to Lim Chien Hong.
That's another effort on goal. Tries to get that in. Baek Seung Hwang, of course, alert to the danger not once but twice. Singapore well should have claimed that, but the Korean custodian, oh, that is a fantastic effort from him. It just looks like his arm's taken a bit of a knock, but really threw himself into that save. And I just do believe that the Korean defense, well, has been exposed a couple of times here today. And that's three! Amirul Azmi! Well, gets in the next one. And the Korean defense just split there. Well, you can't help but feel absolutely awful for Baek Seung Hwan, the keeper. Well, he's had his work cut out for him. Didn't have his entire defense line there to back him up a couple of times over. And he finally breaks a bit. That was a bit too much for even him to react. Amirul Azmi striking when the iron is hot, and that was what was needed. Absolutely marvelous shot. It's now Singapore 4, Korea 1.
Definitely a great well-deserved goal for Amirul Azmi. He set up the play for Lim Chien Hong, a missed shot from him, and of course a follow-through from him again. A great shot, great finish from Amirul Azmi.
Sean Huang. And Singapore will win the benefit of that call. But unfortunate here for Seok Yong-hoon. And I think this is really a tad bit of a worry for Team Korea. Well, I think they've put a lot of pressure on their own keeper because they've concentrated on attack, and it's left Baek Seung Hwan really exposed to the Singapore players time and time again.
Yeah, I mean, they gave too much space for Team Singapore to create an opportunity. I mean, they are definitely focusing on getting back the goals, but of course, defense is also another thing. I mean, the goalie have been doing a great job throughout the whole game preventing, but for how long? You know, these defenders need to really step up and, of course, help him in this situation. But, I mean, give it to the Team Singapore. They have been lethal today. They have been getting the passes going up and been keeping the ball well today. So,
well, I certainly believe that Coach Lim Jin Kwan will have had a few words to say to the lads yesterday, and he's reworked a few things. I think whatever he's done well so far, it seems to be working for Team Singapore.
Yeah, I mean, yeah. Definitely you need to make changes, you know, when things don't go your way. These are the few things that you need to make the changes.
Another close enough opportunity here, and this time, of course, just narrowly missing it. It was number 27, Yong Chun Dien. So, I do believe Korea will need to step it up. They'll have to look at those goals, but they also have to be careful of the defense area. Now it's Vignesa Pasupati. So Korea will win the benefit of that call. And well, I think what's very interesting is Captain Kwang and his men will have to think of a way through. Great interception by Fu Jun Wei, but that's pulled away by Melvin Pabran. The referee, of course, has put paid to that action. It's now for Team Singapore, will be very well back into it.
I think Team Korea need to find a way for the last 5 minutes, and of course, utilizing this 5 minutes, second period, to maybe close up the margin, the goal scoring margin against Team Singapore before the third period.
Sean Huang, a lovely back pass there to Jenmark. Jenmark dragging that through. And Sean Huang decides that he wants to make a call as well. But will miss the target, but it's now with Chiang. Another clash of sorts. And that's moved away by Adi Eriksson. Now Melvin Parbrand. Well, right behind it. Here's Rasmus Janssen. It's Max Parbrand. And that's pulled away by Chung. And of course, the referees call that. So
it's a delayed penalty against Team Singapore.
And this is the part where, of course, Korea might just want to really, well, exploit the moment.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, you're going to definitely use this chance before going to the third period and getting a goal back again to bring the game back to them.
So Thaddeus Tan will sit it out for 2 minutes. And it's going to be interesting to see what exactly, well, Team Korea can come up with here. Singapore, they'll be very eager to make the most of this moment.
Yeah, you have both Parbrand brothers on the right side and Rasmus Janssen, of course, with more to the left side. They got a good attacking trio. Just a matter of the plan on how they're going to penetrate in Singapore's box play.
You've got Captain Pong as well. Yong Chun Yin will just failing to get in on that. It's Melvin Parbrand. And that's pulled away by Team Singapore. Here's Lim Chien Hong. Almost does it here. Nicholas Chua receiving that assist from, well, Lim Chien Hong, but unable to get it past the Baek Seung Wan. And this is what Singapore really needs to do. They need to keep the pressure on. As far as Korea are concerned, they need to, well, just bolster that defensive area, which seems to be weakened time and time again. And, well, if I was in the Korean custodian's shoes today, I'd have it real tough. Talking of which, that's whipped through. And Joshua Low has got it covered.
And great save. Joshua Low, he has been fantastic this game. Of course, from Lim Chien Hong, a great fight. We're talking about size. Size doesn't matter, and you can see Chien Hong creating interception and, of course, creating the chance to score for Nicholas Chua for this.
And all is fair with the captains. Captain Kwang will having a quick word there with the referee, and Kumaresa Pasupati, Thaddeus Tan still waiting his chance to get back on. Mohammad Akmal Sharuddin stretches the length of the court there. Here's Amirul Azri. And Baek Seung Wan, well, holding on to that.
Great opportunity, great ball from Akmal Sharuddin. And of course, Vignesa, an opportunity for you to let goals in his back for this competition.
Well, Vignesa Pasupati, he's been in tremendous form. And the power play is still on, let's not forget. And that cube formation so important. We've seen teams, of course, use that to the maximum to create goal scoring opportunities.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, Korea have to use this opportunity before going to the third period, before Team Singapore comes back with full strength.
Absolutely. And we always talk of box play and how important it is and how you can actually seize the moment. But I do believe, well, an opportunity. Joshua Lowe's kept that away. Oh, absolutely wonderful save there by the Singapore custodian. But having said that, well, the aunt's out of the woods, and that's through. Well, Korea fighting back here. It's now 4-2. We've still got a minute and a little over 30 seconds left, and this is how it all panned out. We are going to show you that strike right now. Something had to give. Well, Joshua Low keeping it away for such a long period of time. Rasmus Janssen got behind it. Well, he is a tricky player. Decided to knock that through. And then, of course, on the rebound, Melvin Parbrand knocking it in. So 4-2, and Korea fighting back. And this is turning out to be an exciting encounter. But Team Singapore will have... I did say they were not out of the woods as yet. And they certainly aren't.
Yeah, I mean, definitely a great goal for Melvin Parbrand. He's a great place at the right time. Right place. I mean, great shot coming in from Rasmus Janssen, definitely. And these are situations where you know you can't give room to these players. 1 minute of loss of focus, you're going to get a chance on goal. I mean, how long can Joshua Lowe protect the goal for how many shots? You know, defense have to really step up to the shot and prevent these players from getting the chance and shots on goal, for sure.
And that just takes off the pressure a little bit of Team Korea. It also, well, reminds Singapore of the fact that they can't be complacent and they can't just sit back on their laurels and think that, you know, four goals is good enough. They've got to keep pushing as hard as they can, like they did in the first and second period. So a minute left in this period.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, the Korean side definitely will boost some confidence getting a goal back. And of course, Team Singapore cruising with a two-goal cushion, definitely, like I say again, it's not enough. You know, they cannot be complacent. They need to stay focused and not create any mistakes in the game.
And that's exactly what we mean. Joshua Lowe there with the save, but the Singapore defense just left exposed. And as Chelsea rightfully pointed out, just a tad bit too much of pressure on the Singapore custodian. I think Singapore will have to be watchful of that. All this time, of course, it was pretty much what was happening with Baek Seung-won. But now the Koreans have read that and they're turning it around against, well, the Singapore, you know, goal.
Yeah, definitely. If you ask me in the first two periods who's the man of the match, I would give it to Joshua Lowe. He's been amazing. He's been the rock. He's been the wall for Team SG. And definitely it's good to see him step up. I mean, he's also at a young age, especially just a couple of competitions for him so far. So really utilizing this opportunity and shows his worth. So this is a good stepping stone for him and a good start for him in a world competition.
Absolutely, I think well said, Chelsea. And we've got just a few seconds left before we close it down at the end of the second period. And that's through! What do you say to that? Nicholas Stewart is elated. It's Singapore 5, Korea 2, just about 2 seconds before the end of the second period. And Nicholas Stewart has helped to restore that three-goal cushion. Here's Nicholas Stewart running through. Well, did stretch it a bit. Decided to drive it through and that just found its way. I don't know whether I put that down to luck or I put that down to accuracy, but that ball just found its path.
I mean, definitely, Nicholas Stewart, he got good technique of shots. I mean, he has not been around for quite a number of international competition. For him to come back in this competition boosts some confidence. I mean, he's still young. He got more years to come ahead of him due to injuries. And it's good to see him back again after a knee injury. And he's one of the players that have great techniques of shot. So
what a
job.
Marvelous finish.
Definitely.
What a marvelous finish to find your way through the defense. And Nicholas George is making it Singapore 5, Korea 2. It's time, of course, to get into the next break. And we are going to run you through whatever transpired in the second period before Shazni and me, Glenn, can take a break. And then we'll be back with you for the third and final period. So right now, let's once again give you that score before we can get to the highlights. And don't forget, well, the game is still open. As my good buddy Shazni always points out, 5 goals is never enough, and 3 goals might just be a slender advantage.
Yeah, definitely. Thank you. Thanks, Dave.
So don't forget, don't go anywhere, as we are still with you, and we are still going to take you through more of this action. Remember, we've got 4 games coming up tomorrow, and it's going to be an exciting time for us. And with those 4 games, also a very good thing to remember that we are going to take you through, well, all the action that will happen as well. So Singapore 5, Korea 2, it's the end of the second period, and we'll be back with you for, well, the third period in just a bit. Here are the highlights. And those were our goal scorers, Mohamed Akmal Sharadin opening the scoring, followed by Max Parbrandt with the equalizer, then their own goal that gave Singapore a 2-1 lead. That was followed by R. Satish and Amirul Azri, of course, knocking in two more goals to make it 4-1 before Melvin Parbrandt reduced the deficit at 4-2, and Nicholas Chua finishing off the second period with a 3-goal lead restored at 5-2 for Singapore. So don't forget, of course, we will be back with you in just a little over 4 minutes, and that's when we resume, well, the third period. So don't forget, that is going to be the third and final period, and we will have a decider as to who qualifies for the World Floorball Championships.
Thank you.
Well, it's time to hit the buzzer for us as well, so we continue with our coverage of the men's qualifiers. And this, of course, just to remind you, is what we've been doing right from the early part of the day. It's the men's World Floorball Championship qualification 2022 AOFC. Remember, three teams have already got through who will be taking part in the Floorball Championship, and that, of course, is Team Philippines, Team Thailand, and Team Australia. One of these two between Team Singapore and Team Korea will also make it through. Korea, of course, doing fairly well to get to this stage, and it's a do-or-die effort for both teams here. Remember, we also have the game for this very event tomorrow. There'll be four games to decide who will take first, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, and eighth place.
Yeah, definitely, Glenn. Definitely good match tomorrow to catch. Do come down to support the teams, and definitely good experience for them to come down to watch the game live.
And just in case you're trying to figure out who are the lads who've been talking right through these last two games, it's Shazni Ramli, former Singapore floorballer, and currently, of course, the man in charge of coaching the teams, and that is Warren Nishab. That's past Joshua Lowe. Korea have got a very early goal in the third period, and they will be excited about one thing. It's Korea Republic fighting back, and here we've got the Korean supporters as well. So it's 5-3.
I mean, a mistake in defense, of course. Great interception by Rasmus Jensen, going for the rebound, follow through with the rebound, and definitely a good goal and definitely a good booster in the first minute of the game in the third period. And well, I mean, looking at Rasmus Jensen, he's limping in the court, you know.
So this is the interesting bit, right? Yeah, he does have a slight injury, it looks like, Rasmus Jensen. He knocked that ball once, didn't get it. Tried to knock it a second time, he didn't get it. The third time he connected and was through. Now, you said slip up, and I really didn't catch that earlier, Chaz. But on the replay, I did. Singapore should have cleared that.
Yeah,
after that first miss.
Yes, I mean, definitely. I mean, time and time again, you can see Team Korea was the first to be going for the rebound. I mean, as defenders, it's very, very important for them to be the first one to get it away. I mean, get it away from the area. You know, if you don't get it to the forwards, at least you get it away from the danger zone. I mean, that's the dangerous area to lose the ball, definitely. Because you lose the ball there, I mean, compared to having possession at opponent's half. I mean, losing the ball at your half, especially behind the goal, it's just one step closer to your own goal.
So rightfully said, now Singapore will have to rework that. And this is one thing that we were talking about. You don't need to take your foot off that intensity pedal. You've got to keep it on. You've got to keep it wired for the entire game. I think the greatest lesson that we've had from two teams who did that in yesterday, one was Team Philippines and the other was Team Thailand. They've been standout teams only for one reason, and that's because they've been wired for those entire three periods.
Yeah, definitely. And Singapore is playing with three lines. They should have fresher legs in, and the intensity should be kept higher and being consistent in every single shift, because they have fresh new players. So definitely, a loss of focus can result to a goal. So I hope they can really step up and get back into the game and start focusing.
And that is so important while I was identifying, you know, a line each from Singapore and from Korea having performed. But it's so important for the best teams to have all three lines performing in a matchup.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, for Singapore, we have quite a number of teams, quite a number of players. We have pool of players that we can even make a three good lines. That's the advantage for Team Singapore.
Well, I think just a defensive slip up from there from Yong Chun Yin earlier. And you got to thank Joshua Lowe for stepping in to keep that danger at bay. That's a solid shot as well. It's really the Parbrand lads who are looking to make a difference, and it's Max Parbrand. He won't hit the target, but he'll be keen on doing that really soon.
Yeah. I mean, these are areas that this player is going to really capitalize on the chance. They should be more patient. I mean, Team Singapore can be more patient, keep the ball. I mean, they are leading by three goals before, and now they are leading by two goals. So I think a bit more patient in the gameplay, and of course, keeping the ball and not losing the ball. You know, these errors can result to a goal. Looks like there's a delayed penalty for Team Singapore. I mean, advantage for Team Singapore, and of course, against Korea.
So we are going to figure out what exactly will pan out in the next bit. But for the time being,
I mean, these are times where you can get a goal scoring opportunity, or even, I mean, using to kill the time of the game. Definitely important time for them. Being patient and always in the ball.
Bit of give and go here between Mohamed Akbal and Nicholas Chua. And I think, just as you mentioned, biding that time out, you want to try and, well, hold control for a bit. We can see that the referee is going to blow that whistle sooner or later.
I mean, Akbal and Nicholas Chua, they would say, like, hey, why is it in a rush? I mean, we keep possession. They need to come and chase the ball. They have to win back the ball. For the power play to start.
And it's Chang Jieqing who's with it still. I think a fairly good tactic here from Team Singapore. They'll have to be very careful about the goal area, of course.
I mean, Korea have to really step up, you know, try to win the challenge, try to win the ball back again. If not, as long as Singapore have possession, I mean, there won't be any changes in the game.
And that'll be the power play advantage for Team Korea. We do have, of course, a delayed penalty, as we did mention earlier. The referee just confirming that.
Looks like a 2 minutes penalty against Team Korea. Another chance for Team Singapore to capitalize on the chance.
And it's actually number 20 for Team Korea,
yeah,
who's on the bench. And I was just trying to figure out, well, when he was going to move. We're trying to decide which of the players will take the seat. So Lee Chun Yong. Now this is the moment that Singapore, just as you mentioned, will have to take advantage of. Here's Sean Huang, to Vignesa. Back to Vignesa. Sean, Amirul Azri, Mohamed Akmal. He's got to decide which way he's going to go. Decides to knock that through. And
of course, you compare the power play between, you know, Thailand, Philippines, and Singapore. Singapore, we have more righty players in the squad. And we need to have a more good lefty players in the team to make the power play a bit more lethal. You can see Thailand, they are dangerously from the left to the right. Both sides, they have strong shooters in the power play. So maybe these are a few things that Team Singapore can explore.
Well, I've always actually looked at that. If you look at a game of hockey, of course, that doesn't make a difference whether you're left-handed or right-handed, because 9 out of 10, you're bound to be right. You play with that one side. But you're so, I think, right about that. I've always looked at games like tennis or table tennis, racket games, or even badminton for that matter. When you have a right and left combination, you tend to cover the entire length of the breadth of the court or the width of the court. And I think I never really put it down to flow ball, but that does serve as such a big advantage, doesn't it?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, you have shooters on the left to right. I mean, it's always easier shooting from the strong side. You can get a one-timer shot in, as compared to shooting from your weaker side. So these are advantages that the team has as compared to Team Singapore. So it's very, very important for us to utilize these opportunities, for sure.
It's Melvin Parbrand taking that through. Denmark right behind it. Denmark Sereda has done fairly well in today's game. It's another gutsy player. He's got decent ball control. It's off to Kumaresa Pasupati, the captain. Marisa's got to decide which man he's got to pick out. Remember, there's still a little under 10 minutes left in this third period of play. Anything could happen. We do know that Korea Republic are a formidable side, and they've got the ability to strike when the iron is hot. 14 seconds left in the power play. Well, Team Singapore really have to, and it's a very important point that you did bring out, Shazni. How often have Singapore converted in the power play when they've had the opportunity? That's a big question, isn't it?
Yeah, definitely. And they need to use this opportunity, because there's still about 9 to 10 minutes of the game left, and they only have 2 goal cushion. And trust me, 10 minutes is a lot of time in floorball. 2 goals especially is nothing. So they need to stay disciplined and need to use this opportunity to their advantage, and of course to get a goal, to get a 3 goal cushion.
try to push that forward. Vignesa Pasupati does have Mohamed Akmal there still behind. You've got Fujun Wei. But something's got to break here. And, well, yes, Isharpal Singh who steps in. Isharpal driving that fairly strong. Still, Mohamed Akmal.
Great technical skill from Akmal Shahruddin. I mean, keeping the ball, good link up with Vignesa Pasupati to keep the ball at opponent's half. Playing behind the goal, moving the defenders and waiting for the right pass for the shot.
Well, technically a very sound player. Lovely, lovely pass there to Fujun Wei. And you really need a finish. Now Singapore will just have to be a bit sharper with their skills. And a quick word, of course, from the coach to his lads. Well, did get a view of that. And there's reason for it because he will want the finish sharper as well. Tariestan driving one through. Now that's pulled away by Adi Eriksson. Here's Rasmus. He's back in. Well, I think just a tad bit of a worry for that hamstring area for him. He's got it taped up. And I do know how beautifully well those colorful tapes work. I've been there, tried and tested.
Yeah, I mean, definitely. I mean, when during this competition, especially back-to-back games every day, injuries tend to happen. Proper recovery is very, very important. And, of course, fatigue is. Usually injuries comes in when you're tired, you know, when you're mentally not ready for certain challenges. And, of course, you overtire yourself in the game. That causes injuries. So,
straight off down to Adi Eriksson. Pulled away by Chiang Jin-Chin. Going for goal, and that's taken by Baek Seung-Wan. Needed a bit of backup there. Well, I certainly think Lee Chi-Yong could have really pounced in on that one, but all said and done. Easy for me to cast my vote from here. Difficult to be on the court and play it out.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, by just watching them, I feel so tired already.
Yeah, you too, me too. So Chiang Jia-Ching really, really trying to make, you know, a few inroads there. Having said that, here's Rasmus Janssen, gets it to Adi Eriksson. Team Singapore still with the benefit of that call. It's a pacey run there. Looking to whip that through! What an absolutely glorious shot from Nicholas Chua. Well, I think Singapore just using the element of surprise here through that rolling substitution. Decided to knock that through, and that was a absolutely fabulous shot from Nicholas Chua. Lovely run there that really broke it down. You needed that assist, and it did come.
A great run down by Chun Yin to make a backhand pass to Nicholas Chua. A great one-timer finish, great shot, put it on target, put it in the net. Great goal from Team Singapore.
So it's Singapore 6 and Korea Republic 3.
Definitely an important goal in this third period. Will determine how the game moves from here. Definitely. And with the game, with about 7 minutes of the game left, Korea need to really step up and, of course, put more pressure on Singapore's half. Definitely.
I certainly believe that. And I certainly believe that. Well, Nicholas Chua on the first 2 days of play was so important with his passes and his assists. And today, well, he's just showing a different side of him. He's been a very important cog in today's game for Team Singapore.
Yeah, definitely. One assist and two goals, I guess, in the game. Great play by him, good vision, always ready to take a shot. And that's what we needed from Team Singapore. That's what that I feel that's lacking for the past 3 games. And they really step up. I mean, my guess, they are going to have the best game today, and looks like they are having the best game today, and they are having fun in court. I mean, that's very important. To have lesser stress, you always perform the best.
That's so true, and that's a beautiful rhyme. Lesser stress and you perform the best. My man, Shazni, you're getting to Wordsworth soon. Absolutely marvelous. So, 8 minutes, 40 seconds in. Well, Shazni and me are certainly enjoying this game, and we do hope you are as well. Here's Lee Chi-Yong dragging that through. Baek Seung-Wan will stand in the way. Melvin Pabran pulls it away now. Max Pabran battling it out, but it is Melvin Pabran who will take this forward. He's moving with conviction. Joshua Lowe steps in the way, and that's what is needed. Bit of a scramble there in the Bronx, and Joshua Lowe says, keep calm, lads. I've got the ball. So, he's not happy.
I mean, goalies would be unhappy when, you know, when players come in and push him or put a stick between the hands or the legs, you know. I mean, he's more concerned about his shoulder injury. He has a shoulder injury, especially right now, so probably felt some pain there.
And we do know that this game is getting physical. We know that Korea Republic, of course, need to score. Rasmus Janssen will be kept away by Joshua Lowe. And Team Singapore, well, going in with the counter now. It's Nicholas Chua once again right there in the fray. Korea Republic throwing themselves at every single well effort that they can. Captain Kwong really trying to lead a fight back from his lads. And he's done fairly well. So we've got to hand it to him. He's kept the spirit of his team up. So Kang Kwon in, still very much involved in this fight back. Having said that, it's about 9.5 minutes in. There's just a little over five, so that's 5.5 minutes. And, well, the referee says, keep calm, lads, and play on.
Yeah, I mean, so Singapore keeping possession, I think, is the key. I mean, especially in this situation, you need to keep the ball in the opponent's half. I mean, losing the ball here, you still got time to react to the situation, you know, rather than losing the ball at their own zone. That's very important at this stage.
Now that's pulled away very smartly by Seo Kyung-hoon. And Korea Republic now pressing right there in that Singapore goal area. Having said that, it's a quick run that we're looking at. Team Singapore know they need to get this away as soon as they can. It's back now with the Korean Republic and back with Team Singapore. Foo Joon Wei now. He's got to pick out his man, and how many times has that ball changed blades and changed hands literally here in that last few minutes?
It has been a great 2 minutes, a great attack from both sides, great counters on both sides. Really high-paced game today. Both sides wants it so much. You can see the hunger of both sides. But definitely Singapore has a 3-goal cushion. So it's really exciting to see what's in store for us for the last 5 minutes of the game.
Well said, Shazni. Absolutely well said. This, of course, is... And let's say the referee also decides to join in the fray. And I have seen that. Well, it's a bit unfortunate. They have to keep out of the way. And sometimes, well, they do take a tumble too, which of course just brings it down. We always talk of unsung heroes. We talk of the defenders, but the referees, how important is their part in this? Now, here's Young Chung taking it away. Well, there seemed to be a good enough opportunity here. He's missed that and just handed possession to Rasmus Janssen. Not the smartest thing to do. Now he's got a bit of help there from Adi Eriksson. Max Barbrand in, just a fight there. And it's Denmark who will fight tooth and nail for it, what he normally does.
Last 4 minutes to decide who goes to the World Cup, World Football Championships in Switzerland in November. Definitely very crucial last 4 minutes of the game. Can Korea come back with 3 goals within 4 minutes? Or Singapore going to keep the lead?
I was about to say, who's the one that's going to be dining on Rosti and Swiss cheese?
Or maybe a good raclette.
Absolutely. So it suddenly looks like, well, Team Singapore will have got the lead, but Team Korea have it all to do here. They are fighting back as much as they can. And keeping the pressure on, that's so important. It's Nicholas Chua, who's still very much with it.
Oh, some unhappiness for Team Korea player number 20.
Well, he has been, well, fairly temperamental in today's game. Was benched once earlier as well.
Yeah, and, I can understand his frustration. You know, the team are down 3 goals. Definitely want to get back the goals and winning the ball.
The stakes are high here.
Definitely, definitely.
You're not just playing for the round robin. You're playing here for, you know, it's pretty much a knockout. So
yeah. And it's just not a competition where you win a gold, silver, or bronze medal. I mean, this is the World Cup qualifiers. I mean, the big stage that the whole world is going to be watching, the World Floorball Championships, you know?
Absolutely. So, number 20 there, we're just going through the motions, Lee Jun Yong. And
I mean, of course, at this stage, Singapore is going to use their experience. They have been to many World Floorball Championships, and some of their players have been in quite a number of competitions, so they know how to react to things, to certain situation when this happens. I mean, 3-goal cushion, they just need to be smart with the ball, keep the ball, and the slot is definitely theirs. And of course, Team Korea, they need to come up with a plan, you know, how they're going to penetrate the Singapore defense, how they're going to capitalize on the errors that are being made by the Singapore defense, and of course, pushing more men high up to win the ball at their zone, at the opening zone, and capitalize on the chances they can have in the last 3 minutes or so.
So this, of course, is, I think, the best analysis that we've had. Thank you, Shaz, for that. And of course, 3.5 minutes, a little over 3 minutes left, and it really is going to get heated. There's no doubt about it. Singapore 6, Korea 3. Here we go into probably that final part of this game. Pulling away just in time, Max Barbrand. Now Korea will fire on all cylinders, there's no doubt about it. It's left to Team Singapore to push back as much as they can. Here's Fu Junwei. Well, Junwei, well ambushed there by Adi Eriksson and Captain Kang Kwan In.
A slight nudge there from back from Fu Junwei.
Isharpal Singh moves it away. Here's Akmal Charuddin. Waited straight off the board there for Junwei. Well, Junwei losing possession, and it looks like, well, Melbourne Parbrand will take this through. Yes, Max Parbrand tries to drive it. Well, blocked there by
Team Singapore. You can see Singapore. The Singapore defense, they're already putting body in the line, and this is more how it is to be. Putting defense, putting body in line instead of a goalie. Great effort from Team Singapore. I mean, Korea have been trying hard throughout the game to penetrate in, but nearly impossible.
Well, Kang Kwan In, well, doing extremely well. Adi Eriksson now picking it up. The referees call that.
Honestly, great spirit from Team Korea. You know, being 3 goals now, they know how important is every single second and every single shift that they have left in the game. You can see they're definitely going to utilize that moment and every single moment that they can have.
Well, you did mention Rasmus Janssen. He's definitely got a problem with his leg. He has been limping off each time. So I think, but he's really giving his heart out, so hats off to him. Well, these are really quality athletes, not just the lads who are playing for Team Singapore, but the lads for Team Korea. Well, that's a great spirited fight that they're putting on. Here's Jen Mok. Well, if you ever thought that it was going to get aggressive, and that's how aggressive it does get here. We saw that yesterday between Australia and the Philippines as well. And here's Jenmark holding his own. And that's how physical it gets.
I mean, definitely. I mean, both teams want to win. No one wants to lose. And, of course, in the last 2 minutes or so, this game intensity going to increase. And Korea going to go hard as possible. I mean, what Singapore needs to do is just keep the ball, pass the ball around, and then, of course, convert any opportunity they can have. There's no rush in them. They got 3 goals.
Satish, you've got Nicholas Chua, you've got Lim Jen Hong, who's right in front of the goal.
Looks like Korea is really going for every single challenges and putting all the bodies in line as much as possible.
Well, I wouldn't believe that, but Max Parbrand actually missing out on an opportunity. And Joshua Lowe's picked it up. And I guess it's just in the moment, you know, the moment of urgency. Korea Republic now just playing all out, and rarely see young Parbrand miss an opportunity like that. He actually missed a shot earlier, which could have well been detrimental for Team Singapore. So under a minute left, and the game is heating up. It's clashes there with player on player as well. And in the Korean team, Kang Jin-yol clashing there with Seo Kyung-hoon. Having said that, 35 seconds left. Well, Singapore still, of course, are at 6, Korea Republic at 3. And it's going to be interesting to see which of these two teams will get it through. Here's Melbourne Parbrand. They're just doing all that he can. Team Singapore once again in possession. Here's Akmal Charuddin. Well, Singapore will try and play out the spirit if they can't score. Remember, it's just seconds left. Akmal Charuddin against the boards, but that's not going to make too much of a difference. And as they figure it,
a few more seconds, and of course, I believe the last slot going to go to Team Singapore. It's just a matter of seconds for the game to end, to decide for the slot. But I think more or less it will be decided based on the game.
Well, I do believe with that time period, it's not going to be easy. And the fans just counting it down. And that's full time. What a win here for Team Singapore. Much needed relief. Singapore 6, Korea 3. Well, hats off to Korea for putting in their maximum best as far as this event is concerned. Hats off to Team Singapore for pulling off a victory. And Singapore will be flying to Switzerland in November to take part in the Floorball World Championships. Oh, what a joy it's going to be here for the home fans who've turned up. But all said and done, what a fight back from Korea Republic. Well, they did fight tooth and nail for this. They've been a wonderful team to watch, and it's been a pleasure to have them in this tournament itself. So Singapore, in the qualification process, left it too late, and they finally secured it. And I can't help but extend the joy of my co-commentators.
Oh, I'm enjoying myself, definitely. And definitely, I would love Singapore to go for the World Floorball Championships. And tickets are booked for them to Switzerland in November. Definitely a great time to watch. And most probably, traveling to Switzerland again to watch them play, for sure. But it's on stands.
And that, of course, is Shazni Ramli, not just the lad we call Mr. Floorball Singapore, but also a man involved now with grooming and actually mentoring the under-19 team, involved in so many schools, with bringing out young talent, scouting for them, and helping them get ready for the big stage. So I can't put it past him. And, of course, my co-commentators who joined me previously, and that would include Jared Thun, the goalkeeper, Yoshan, our very own defender, who was with me for so many games, Mindy Lim, the forward, and more importantly, my good mate who stuck by me through many games, Fu Junwei, who is a part of this team. So definitely a great joy here for all my co-commentators. So having said all that, it's now time, of course, for us to look at the prize presentation.
The player of the match for Singapore will be presented by Ms. Louise Kirk, Senior Manager of Coaching Development from Sport Singapore. And the player of the match from Singapore goes to number 9, Nicholas Chua. Presenters and players, please stay for a group photo. Thank you, Mr. Choi and Ms. Kerr.
This is how it panned out in the game, as we take you through it. Well, that opening shot coming in from Akmal Shahruddin to give us the lead to make it 1-0 Singapore. And then, of course, Shazni, that was a very, very, very well-executed shot. He was at the right place and just took total advantage of it.
Yeah,
and
definitely. I mean, you have two players in front of goal.
And then, of course, this moment. So Max Barbrand with the reply as he equalized to make it 1-1. And Joshua Lowe, of course, taken by surprise. And Korea Republic were really on level terms here fighting back.
I mean, this is the next goal that changes the game. Great pass down to Vignesop from Vignesop Paspati to Akmal Shahruddin. And, of course, a pass in and deflection from the defender, which gets them the lead 2-1.
So that unfortunate own goal for Siok Yong-hoon that made it 2-1 for Team Singapore. Now that was the end of the first period. Into the third period.
And definitely this is a power play goal from Team Singapore. Great pass from Nicholas Chua, the man of the match today. Great pass to Satish for a one-timer shot.
So it was 3-1 at that point of time.
This is one of the highlights of the day, definitely. a great run by Amir Razri, getting the diagonal pass to Lee Chen Hong, and of course the miss shot by Lee Chen Hong, but a great follow through from Amir Razri to score to the top left corner of the goal.
So that was 4-1, and it certainly looked like Team Singapore was firmly in command. But then let's not forget that Team Korea were very hungry. Rasmus Janssen tried to get one through, and then of course, right place at the right time, and Melvin Parbrand put them back on a fighting pedestal. And it was right here at this end of this period we were looking at that score at was going to be 4-2. But there was still one more goal to come at the end of the second period, and that was a bit of a surprise.
Yeah, this is the icing on the cake at the end of the second period, for sure. A great goal, a great placing, and a great shot by Nicholas Chua. Great accuracy, great technique, perfect finish, and a scoreline 5-2.
So Nicholas Chua just making it look so easy, but actually that was a well thought of and extremely well executed shot.
And this is the goal by Rasmus Janssen, a mistake by Amir Razri. This is where we talk about three consecutive shots till he scored a goal.
And, well, Rasmus Janssen just giving them a bit of hope to make it 5-3. I have to say, just reflecting back on the Nicholas Chua shot earlier, there was almost like a golf swing.
This is definitely one of the best goals of the game. A great run by Chun Yin by the left side, and great backhand pass for Nicholas Chua to make a one-timer shot in.
So that's 6-3, and that's what I mean by the golf swing, right? He's actually got that. He stays with that follow-through, normally. So it really was an exciting one, and Singapore just doing enough, but great fight back. As Kwan, of course, tried to pull it back here. But at the end of the day, it certainly was, well, Team Singapore to qualify as they finished Singapore 6, Korea Republic 3, to cap off a win and qualification for the World Floorball Championships, where they will join Australia, Team Philippines and Team Thailand. But hey, don't go anywhere, because we've still got the goal scorers. It was Akmal Sharuddin, of course, who came in. It was Akmal Sharuddin who came on, of course, with the first strike, followed by Max Parbrand, and then Ar Satish. Amirul Azri followed suit with Melvin Parbrand, Nicholas Chua, Rasmus Janssen, and then Nicholas Chua giving them the win. So here's what it is: Singapore 6, Korea Republic 3, and that's how it finished. Well, don't forget, of course, we've enjoyed staying with you right through this entire qualification process, and it's going to be time for us to look at. We will have a bit more action. So let's not forget, we will have a bit more action as we get into more stuff tomorrow. But we'll let you know about that when the games, of course, kick off. For now, let's end this day right here in the OCBC Arena. Thank you for joining us and for staying with us right through this entire day. Singapore have qualified after getting the better of Korea Republic 6-3. It's time for Shazni Ramli, my good mate and buddy, and of course me, Glenn Mascarenhas, to shut shop and ship out of here. So thank you, Shazni, for joining me.
Thank you, Glenn, for having me, and definitely an honor to witness this game and to come into this game. Thank you so much.
So from all of us here, it is good night, and do have a good rest. We'll catch you again tomorrow when we catch you live on your screens and devices again.